Hey guys, this is now my part two of my saddle blanket collection, and now I am on to my general purpose and show jumping saddle blankets. Quick update, as I kind of like to do in all my videos. I recently had Lockington horse trials, well, 2 days ago. It was good after dressage with coming second, but show jumping, of course, he's not very good at show jumping, especially because he's only just started moving up to higher heights. And so we had three down, I think, two or three, not sure. And so then we went to sixth place, and then after cross country, oh, it's so annoying. Cross country, he was going so well, as he usually does now in cross country, really, really well. And then came up to a trichina, which I will insert a picture now here. And funny story, the ditch next to it, the open ditch, which was, you know, reasonably big, when I first got him in the first year that I was training him, I guess, that was the ditch that kind of turned him off ditches for a long time. And so then once again, this trichina, he came up to it and he was like, yeah, fine, it's a jump. Wait a minute, there's a ditch underneath it. And it was like quite a large ditch. And it was a pretty high jump, so he couldn't really stop and then clamber over it, which is sometimes what he does in cross country. Tried again. He was too scared of it. Tried again. He was still like, oh, but then he was like, yeah, I'll jump it. Oh, wait, I have no momentum now. So, unfortunately, we were eliminated. And yes, so I'm going to go back there hopefully in the next couple of weeks or days. I'm going to go down and go over it with Megan and stuff, like heaps of times, just get him really into the mode of jumping it and jumping trichinas, because I know there's one at Lakes and Craters. So I'll be doing that heaps and just really working on it. He jumps open ditches fine now, but as I say, this trichina was a lot bigger. He's actually jumped heaps of trichinas before in cross country, but this one I guess was just a bit more obvious and you just couldn't see it. I mean, you could see it a bit more than the other ones that he's done perfectly fine in cross country. So thought I'd just give you a quick update, and now onto the saddle blankets. So this first one is from a company that I have done a promotion video for in the past. It is QJ Riding Wear, and I bought this saddle blanket for that video, and I just got it on like Gumtree or Facebook or one of those groups for a really cheap price. So this is my QJ Riding Wear saddle blanket. It is navy and it's got kind of this interesting wavy kind of pattern. Then it's got on both sides the QJ Riding Wear logo. It is GP, I believe. And it's got these really quite short billet straps. And billet strap down here. It's kind of, I haven't really washed it that well. I have actually washed it, but just not very well. So it's still very kind of gross. So as you can see, it's got the QJ Riding Wear label there. And I don't use it very often. I actually don't think I've used it since that thing. Just because I have so many others and I have a particular brand that I like using all the time. But yes, that is that one. Now this next one is also very, very dirty. I did wash it again, but it's kind of it's got all these kind of water marks on it, which is really annoying, but you can get them off. I just haven't been bothered to. But I got this one and the next three from Horseloverz in America. The postage was ridiculous. Probably won't be buying from them again just because it is so expensive internationally. But this was when I was dyeing all my rainbow saddle blankets, and I thought, you know, whatever, I'll get heaps of them and then it'll be worth it because then I can just sell them on. So I got a lot of white plain saddle blankets because they are a lot cheaper in the US. Even the good quality ones are a lot cheaper. So I got a heap of them, and I also grabbed a couple that I wanted to use. So this is Lietia collection. It's a baby pad, so it doesn't have a billet strap here, but I thought it was just heaps cute. It's brown. I don't know if you can tell because it has this little peace sign there, which is so cute. Little peace line, yay. But it's real cute. And I'm not a huge fan of this sort of shape, but I haven't really used it that much, just because my saddle blanket slips. I tend to slip with my saddle unless I put these billet straps onto the saddle. So I usually have to use this with one of those. It's a rubber pad and it's got these little circles in it, and it stops it from slipping. So I have to always use that with this, which is annoying, but I'll deal with it. Now this next one, I really actually love this green colour, but I don't use it too much just because I always use my other Lemieux pads, to be honest. But this is a Tough Rider pad. These are really very, very cheap and they actually last really well. I think they're about $15 or something. So this is an apple green one, and then it's white underneath, which is kind of silly, but you know, not complaining. And it's kind of got these kind of diamond shaped, you know, stitching across it. It's just a really simple pad. These are actually really very big considering the size of a normal GP or jumping pad, and they're really quite long. So yes, that if you're interested in them, they are very cheap, but just remember they're very big, so if you have a not so big horse, they will not fit them very well. They will look huge on it. Now this next one is the same. It is my old cross country pad. Again, once again, Tough Rider, as I said, it's the same pad. It is in ocean blue and I absolutely loved this. It was very, very good for cross country while I had it. It has got a lot less bright blue since I've had it. Good pads. Definitely worth the $14. And this is the same one, but I have obviously never used it. I'm trying to work out what to do with it because I don't really have any use for it, so I might include it in a giveaway later or sell it or something like that. Not sure. Now this next one was my first ever white saddle blanket. It is Roma. I got it from Horseland. It's got this kind of, I know, triangle of fluff here, so it stops it from slipping and it also helps the wither not get rubs and stuff. So this one, I don't know, it might still be competition quality, but I have not used it for competition for a long time now. It's got this, it's really annoying, but it's got like a hoof black stain on it right there. And I mean, I reckon I could use it for lessons and stuff at my trainers, because I really like white, the look of white saddle blankets for training at the moment. They look very classy and American. So this next one is for sale and I got it for like $100. It was a really expensive saddle blanket. I'm trying to sell it for like 40 or 50, and yeah, I don't know if that's a lot or whatever, but it is a swallowtail GP saddle blanket. It has no billet straps, so my saddle eats it. And as you can see, it's got the Rambo pad there. And it's such a big puffy pad, really like it, but as I say, just doesn't fit my saddle very well. So this next one is for my school, when I used to do inter-schools, because I can't anymore because I'm no longer at school. Yes, so happy. But this is my Scotch equestrian team pad. I've had it for ages. I was probably actually supposed to give it back to school, but never really happened. And it's got black on the inside. I think it is Grange, yeah. So from Bonnetts, aka Saddleworld. And then it's got my school emblem on this side with kind of our blazer material there. So it's actually a really cool pad. I used it quite a bit, not at competitions, and so now it's quite dirty. And this next one is another kind of club saddle blanket. It is from McLaren District's Riding Club, when I used to do their riding club, which I stopped in 2013, I think. It's black, yellow and red, as you can tell. And then it's got their emblem thing there, or logo or whatever. It's actually a really nice pad. Really look it. So this next one is an Equissage pad. I think I got it at, I won it at a competition, I'm not sure, but I think it was Narracourt. And it's just this plain black pad, and Not sure what brand it is, but then it's got Equissage on this side. And I actually use it quite often compared to my other pads just because it's something simple and nice. Like, I don't really have many other black ones aside from that McLaren Districts one. So there's Equissage. Okay, next one is my Polo, HB Polo University one. I've had it for what, ages, it seems like. And I really do like it. I love this cobalt blue colour, but I don't use it that much anymore just because I always use my other ones and it's pretty out there. But I really like this pad, it's super nice. It's from a few years ago, HB Polo season, I don't know, however many years ago. But I just love the combination of brown, white and cobalt, really good. And gold, my favourite colours. This next one is, I think, no, one of my first ever rainbow saddle blankets that I dyed, and it is just the one that I keep because it's this material of this particular saddle blanket. It's practical choice. I think I got them, like three of them, from Horseland for 50 or something like that, and they're just not the nicest feeling of saddle blankets. They're kind of like satiny and weird. The colour doesn't stick to it as well, so I didn't want to sell this on, but this is my rainbow saddle blanket that I use sometimes. It's really nice. And now on to my favourite brand, as you know, for saddle blankets, Lemieux. So this is my burgundy one, which I thought was red, but it turned out it was burgundy. But I really like it. I've only used it once and it's got the waffle, this kind of waffle fabric underneath. And as I say, I've talked about these pads for forever, or a lot now, so I don't really, I'm not going to say too much about it. But in comparison, someone asked me the comparison colour of, go away. Anyway, these are my two burgundy-ish coloured pads. Someone asked me to do a comparison kind of them. So this one is, I think, raspberry, and this one is burgundy. It doesn't look that different, but obviously this one's a lot more red and this one is burgundy for sure. So it's a raspberry coloured one, as I just said. I've still got my Interschools logo on it, and this one is that more, I don't know, softer fabric on the inside, which is a lot nicer. And on this side, same thing. I haven't washed this one since Interschools. Then this colour, I absolutely love it. It is the royal blue coloured one. This used to be Charlie, my first horse's colour, and I've always just loved it. It's really nice, but it's very out there, so I don't use it that much aside from at my jumping lessons and stuff like that. But it would be the best colour for eventing, I reckon. So pretty! And this one is also fabric on the inside. Now this was my first ever Lemieux pad. It is the, it's waffle on the inside, first of all. And it is navy with this kind of gold, yellow trimming, piping, or whatever you want to call it. Now this shows how Lemieux pads age when you've used them a lot. As you can see, it's got those, that kind of, I don't know, it's got holes in it and rubs kind of thing. But I don't know if they've improved that or not, because none of my pads have since started getting holes or rubs here. So I'm not sure if they've improved on that or not. But it doesn't seem to be that different really. So this is how a Lemieux pad ages, and I still use it all the time. So yes! Now these ones are still very dirty because I use them at Lockington and I didn't want them to be wet when I filmed this video. But this is my show jumping pad that I use at competitions. As you can see, this is how it gets dirty with my boots. But I really like it. It's waffle on the inside and very dirty, as you can see. Alright, so this is my cross country one that I obviously use for cross country. This one's kind of an odd sort of fabric. These blue ones are not so suede. I think they're a bit different. They're called luster pads, so I think the fabric of them is a bit different. They're not suede like the other ones. But anyway, this is my ocean blue one that I use in cross country and has stains all over it from his saddle because he was very sweaty because it was very hot on Sunday. Yeah. So this is just the one that I use for cross country. Love it. Will never slip on a cross country course, which is what I love so much about it. And it's fabric underneath. Now this one's kind of a funky one. I use it actually quite often just because it's something a bit different and I really like it. It is by HighlineOutfitters.com and it is this, it looks so creased and gross, but it looks good on the horse, I promise. But it is this shell saddle blanket that I also got from Horseloverz back in 2013 when I did this order. And it is this apple green kind of colour, maybe a bit more mint than apple, minty apple green, with this white piping. And it looks really cool under a saddle. And everyone's always like, is that a shell saddle blanket? I'm like, hell yeah. Oh yeah, I know my fashion. So this next one is my first ever saddle blanket that I got. It is Zilco International, which used to be quite a common brand. One of my old saddle that I had for Charlie, that is actual Zilco International, but they don't do saddles anymore. But it's a good saddle, but it's got a lot of things wrong with it, like a lot of old saddles. The gullet doesn't just go straight, it goes like that and can pinch the horse's spine and stuff like that. Anyway, more you know. But this is it used to be a very royal blue saddle blanket, but since it has faded a lot, I used this all the time when I had Charlie. I loved it so much and I still love it. I don't even think I've used it with Jerry yet, but it is a very nice saddle blanket. It's white underneath. Silly people making saddle blankets white underneath. God. But it has obviously aged really, really well. It's a good brand. And it's got like, I don't know what happened. Maybe some like detergent got on it and it like dyed that bit white. Really like this saddle blanket. Only thing I don't like is these are just, I don't know, they don't have any Velcro, so you have to like feed the thing through it instead of just, you know, Velcroing it on. And yeah, so sorry if you can hear a baby crying in the background. My niece is out there. Chloe, shush, I'm trying to film a video. Anyway, so I hope you like this video, and they are all my saddle blankets. Way too many. Way, way too many. But anyway, I'm hoping to sell some. Okay, gotta go. See you guys. Hope you enjoyed the video.